We'll see now the problem. This is the very first problem. If they ask you, find out the stability order of the carbocation, of these carbocations. So you can notice here you have first molecule where you have three alkyl group, three methyl groups are there, three chlorine are there, then two methyl group, and finally you have benzylic group. So now we have an idea that we know the tertiary butyl group should be the most stable, being it has the 9 hyperconjugative forms, plus it has the plus I effect, right? And then you know that you have this secondary butyl, right? Secondary carbocation, you have here 6, then you have here 6 resonating structures, right? 6 hyperconjugative form. You have here benzyl, right? So we need to find which is more stable here. So how you can compare? Just now we have seen the in general overall stability, okay, of the molecule. So you can see here, as you can see, 10 H is for hyperconjugation, because you have 9 alpha hydrogens here. Moreover, you have plus I effect here. Here you have 4 resonating structure, but slight minus effect is I there. Minus I effect is not dominant here. Dominant is resonance. So therefore, we have written the stability of this. You have here 7 hyperconjugative structures, that is 6 alpha plus. Inductive effect is also there, but here overpower is hyperconjugation. Okay, so 6 alpha hydrogens are there. And chlorine being electronegative, this is withdrawing the electron from this carbon. Okay, so being electronegative in nature, it will withdraw. Withdraw means already it is deficient, it will destabilize it, so will be the least stable. So therefore you can note down here this pattern, and the preference also we give here. Fine. So if you compare these two, we have already seen you have more resonating structures, plus you have plus I effect of 3 methyl group, while here it is slightly minus I effect of C6H5, but it has 4 resonating forms here. The next molecule you can see here, tertiary butyl secondary carbocation, you have here vinyl and you have here one alkyne also, and we know the answer here. Tertiary butyl should be the most stable, being more hyperconjugation here, inductive effect. Then comes here this where you have hyperconjugation, inductive effect, sp3 carbon. This is vinyl, which is having sp2, more electronegative, will be less stable as compared to sp3. Here the alkyne one is sp carbon, most s character, means most electronegative compared to all this molecule, destabilizes the most carbocation, and therefore we have this order for the carbocation stability. Okay, so the next is this example, and I hope you can find out the logic and behind the stability of carbocation for these molecules. So if you notice here, for this carbocation you have 2 methyl groups, while in this case you have one side methyl and the other side is OCH3 group. If you remember, OCH3, oxygen is electronegative, okay, will not give its electron, but you have a plus I effect here, electron donating group, which will donate its electron, and the oxygen will give its electron. So what kind of effect will come here? It is the plus M effect, right? Plus M effect, electron donating will stabilizes the carbocation. And now here at this side, you are having C double bond OCH3. C double bond O, this CH3, this is the electron withdrawing group, right? It is withdrawing the electron. It is already deficient. If it is having withdrawing the electron, means it will destabilize the carbocation. So I hope you understood the stability order. This OCH3 will be the highest stable. Why? Because here you have plus M effect, which is the major role, playing major role here. You have here hyperconjugation also, because of the 3 alpha hydrogen present. Okay, and you have plus I effect, which is not overpowering. You have only one CH3, so the major role is here, plus M effect here. Okay, and then comes your the secondary carbocation stability, because here you have 7 hyperconjugative forms, right? 6 alpha hydrogen, and which is playing the major role here. Okay, and then comes the electron withdrawing group, which is creating the minus I effect, minus M effect. Okay, minus M, though it has the 3s3 4 hydrogens, 4 hyperconjugative forms because of the 3 alpha, and plus I effect is not as strong. So basically the square which I have highlighted are playing the major role. So mesomeric is playing the most role, which is generating the resonance here basically. So as I told you, RHI role, so resonance, mesomeric effect is here creating the resonance. So resonance is stabilizes this most, and then comes a hyperconjugation here, and then finally, because it is electron withdrawing group, that is destabilizing the carbocation. As I told you, electron withdrawing group destabilizes. S character increases, that destabilizes. Okay, and the bridgehead carbocation destabilizes. And this is a note you have to keep in your mind. Whenever the molecule is having mesomeric and as well as inductive effect, most of the time mesomeric effect overpower the inductive effect. Okay, so we consider the molecule with respect to mesomeric effect. Now in these molecules, you can say it is having the nitro substituted ortho, meta and para. Okay, and we know the nitro is meta directing, right? And it is electron withdrawing group, isn't it? It is electron withdrawing group, and we know the electron withdrawing group destabilizes the carbocation. So since all are having, we will see which is destabilizing the most, will be the having the least stable carbocation, right? And since minus M effect, as I told you, the mesomeric effect occurs only on ortho, or you can say works only on ortho and para position. Okay, so mesomeric effect works only on ortho and para position. It doesn't work on meta, okay, position. So if you have a functional group here at meta position, there you can think of inductive effect but not mesomeric effect. So inductive effect here again, it is minus I effect, right? Minus I effect electron withdrawing group. Here it will be minus M effect in both the cases, right? So we know mesomeric effect is more powerful, right? So if you compare the three, this is having the weak effect because it is minus I. Minus I effect is weak as compared to minus M. So minus I effect is weak means this destabilizes the carbocation less as compared to these two, isn't it? And again, if you compare the ortho and para, the ortho being close to this benzyl group will destabilizes more than compared to para, because it is far from this group. So you can find out that this is having minus I effect. Among the three, this is the more stable. Then comes the para one, and then the ortho. Ortho, because the mesomeric effect works only on ortho and para, electron withdrawing group destabilizes the carbocation. Ortho will destabilize the most because it is close to the carbocation, and then comes para. And here, since you don't have mesomeric, mesomeric effect is more strong, means more destabilizes. Here you have minus I effect. Among the three, this is the most stable one. So like that, you can find out the stability of carbocation with respect to the mesomeric effect. This is another example. And since we have covered already this type of benzylic type of molecules category, right? You can solve it right now. You can pause my video and solve it. Okay. So basically, the example so far we have covered, it is important for 11th student, 12th students, BSc students also. You can see in your question paper these type of questions for 11th 12th competitive exams. So far whatever topic we have covered here, the problems, it is important for all of you. So if you see here, this is benzylic substituted. So for benzylic substitution, we think of mesomeric effect, right? So we will see all our para substituted here. Now we'll see OH, NH2, CH3, Cl. Now among these, OH is oxygen is electronegative, right? So since it is electronegative, it will not give its electron here to donate, isn't it? Easily. Nitrogen being electron donating group, and it's not very strong electronegative, it will donate its electron and stabilizes its carbocation. CH3 will normal show the inductive effect and then will stabilizes. So here you can see the plus I effect, here you can see the plus M effect. Chlorine being the most electronegative will not give its electron, it will try to withdraw the electron from here, will destabilize the carbocation most. So if you notice the stability order, the NH2 one will be the most stable because you have a plus M effect here. Then comes the OH because it has the plus M effect, but as compared to NH, because both are electron donating, right, groups. If you see over NH2 and OH, it is electron donating groups only, but OH oxygen being electronegative, it will not give easily. Okay, so compared to nitrogen and oxygen, and nitrogen will easily give, so more plus M effect as compared to the OH group because oxygen more electronegative. Then comes the plus I effect of CH3. Remember, mesomeric effect overpower the inductive effect. Okay, and then minus M or minus I effect because of the presence of electron withdrawing group destabilizes the carbocation most. So I hope you got the same answer, right? So it's easy, isn't it? We have learned the concept about it and we are solving the problem, and I hope you can solve any problem comes to you like that. This is the next problem, and now onwards we'll discuss a few problems which is more important for BSc and MSc student, especially MSc students or CSIR gate students. For higher degree students, this kind of problems most of the time comes. Now, so as you can see here, four structures. We have seen a few earlier that cyclopropyl one is the most stable one as compared to the triphenyl carbocation. And then you have to see tertiary carbocation, you have already seen. Now we need to decide with this, isn't it? This carbocation. So we'll see what is the effect. So now you can see this structure is more stable. Most stable because it is having the banana shape electron cloud. We have seen already the diagram here, orbital picture. Pi orbital overlap is there. Easily it can overlap with this and carbocation, vacant orbital of carbocation, and transfer its electron. So most stable one compared to triphenyl, it's stable, having 10 resonating structure. And then comes the 3-methyl, which is having the hyperconjugation. 10 hyperconjugating form resonating structures are possible because it has 9 alpha carbon or 9 alpha hydrogens are there. And this is the least stable one because if you compare, if you see with respect to this carbocation, the alpha position, and there are 3 alpha which is having only one proton in each case. So total 4 resonating structures are possible because of the 3 alpha as compared to this one. So, and this is a non-planar structure as well. So if you see the stability order, this structure will be the least stable. Okay, least stable carbocation because it has the least hyperconjugative or least resonance structure or delocalized structures. And I told you already that resonance we give preference most as compared to hyperconjugation, and then comes to inductive factor. So this is the next example here. You can see different structures here. We are seeing some very first time. This is called the tropylium cation. This is again diaryl cation here, benzylic substituted. Okay, substituted benzylic group. You have here substituted allylic carbocation. This is substituted benzylic carbocation. This is substituted allylic carbocation. And this is, you can see the aromatic. Okay, aromaticity is there. okay, aromatic carbocation. Now we'll see the stability of it, and you can see aromatic carbocations are the most stable because of the aromaticity it has. It will be most stable. Moreover, it has three methyl groups. So because of that, it has more resonating structures are possible. Okay, each methyl hydrogen will participate and it's give electron to this positive charge. More hyperconjugative forms are there. Plus I effect is there, so will be the most stable one. All the aromatic compounds are having a more stability as compared to the other one. Here again tropylium carbocation comes next. It is again generating, it is planar in structure and it is having the aromaticity. This positive charge will be delocalized in the ring. So will be the next in the line after the cyclopropyl carbocation. It has more, okay, more characters here. It has a resonance here. It has hyperconjugation. It has inductive. That's why most stable. Then comes this one, resonance. And then comes this your CH positive disubstituted, diaryl substituted here. It has seven resonating structures being compared to it. So this is the aromatic one. Therefore, it is more stable as compared to this one. Okay. The disubstituted benzylic one. And then you have the substituted allylic group here. So after benzyl comes the substituted allyl group. This is more stable. This is the compare in this list. This is the least stable one. So you can see here this positive charge is in resonance also here, and you have the this is the tertiary carbocation. You can see here you have CH3. So total seven hyperconjugative structures are possible because of 6 alpha. You have the inductive effect as well. So we know we have seen this stability order earlier that this will be the more stable as compared to the substituted allylic group. Okay, so this is the stability order, and you can always find out the stability with respect to aromaticity, most stable. Then comes the resonance, how much delocalization is there, and along with that what other factors are present, hyperconjugation, inductive effect and all. So this will be the last problem for today's lecture, and in this example you can see we have all bicyclic or compounds, right? You have here, and the carbocations are the bridgehead carbocations. If you see, the bridgehead carbocations are there. So basically we are seeing here the stability order of these bridgehead carbocations, which are more stable. So any idea, do you know which will be the most stable here? So, and we have seen already the Bridge rule, that according to it, it says that the carbocation at the bridgehead is not stable, right? So all the three are having means it is not that much stable, right? So we'll see the solution here. Here this one is the most stable because it is having the larger size. Okay, the ring size is larger, so the flexibility is there. Therefore this carbocation compared to the other two is more stable. But what about the other two? If you notice this structure here, you have the two bridge carbons, right? Two bridge carbons. With respect to that, if you draw imaginary line here, so if you notice with this imaginary line, there are three boxes, you can three cyclobutane ring, you can imagine, right? Three cyclobutane ring. Actually there are two, but if you draw this imaginary line, so this is three, okay, cyclobutane ring. And being sp2 hybridized carbocation, it should be trigonal planar, but for that it should have 120 degree bond angle. If you notice here, for cyclobutane, the bond angle is 90 degree only. So there is a huge strain in the molecule, right? So the strain in the molecule is there. Therefore, the stability is less as compared to the first one. Smaller the size of ring, higher will be the strain, and therefore the stability will be less. Higher the strain, lesser the stability. In this structure, while you can see, if you draw imaginary line, it is creating a cyclopropane ring. And for cyclopropane ring, we know has the 60 degree angle. So the bond angle and the other two is having 90 degree because two butane ring, you can imagine cyclobutane ring. So basically here the bond angle is more or less means more strain is there as compared to the previous structure. Therefore the stability of this carbocation is the least as compared to the other two. So in that way you can find out the stability order of bridgehead carbocations also. So I hope for all of you that today's lecture will be helpful and you can solve now any problems comes to you on carbocations. All the best. See you in the next video. Bye.